John Kelly stuns Laura Ingraham when he reveals secret weapon to destroy corrupt Democrats. The left likes a susceptible and distracted public, which is exactly why Robert Mueller recently announced charges against Paul Manafort that were irrelevant to the Russian investigation. Unfortunately for them, it looks like the tables are about to turn as John Kelly has since revealed his secret weapon to Laura Ingraham, and it's about to destroy every corrupt Democrat out there. As has been made more than clear at this point, the indictments currently being broadcast all over the news was nothing more than a distraction to keep Americans looking in the right direction. Literally. What they don't want you doing is looking at members of the liberal left, because that's where the real corruption is. Of course, many people didn't think it was a coincidence that there was a completely irrelevant indictment that came out of an investigation into Russia at a time when Hillary Clinton and Barack Obama were being exposed for the parts they played in the Trump dossier in the Uranium One scandal. Knowing they had to do something in terms of damage control, they decided to link President Donald Trump to something he had no part in doing. For those unaware, the charges against Manafort don't involve Russia, they don't involve Trump, as it happened for several years prior to 2014, and Manafort was actually working for Hillary's campaign manager's brother, Tony Podesta, who also happened to be a Democratic power lobbyist, at the time of his illegal misdeeds. Unfortunately for them, it looks like their desperate attempt to distract America just pissed off the wrong person. In fact, White House Chief of Staff John Kelly most recently appeared on Laura Ingraham's show on Fox News to say that he had a secret weapon that he was getting ready to use to destroy all corrupt Democrats once and for all. In short, Kelly is set on investigating the true criminal actions of the left and bringing them to light, but he doesn't want a circus show like what Mueller currently has going. I think probably as a layman looking at this kind of thing, we need to find someone who is very objective, who can get to the bottom of these accusations, he explained, referring to a special counsel who should be appointed to investigate the situation. That's the difference between the left and the right. Democrats are so eager to paint Manafort as a bad guy because it might make the GOP look bad, and not a single person is fighting to defend this indictment because everyone on the right wants corruption gone just as much as the left is pretending that they do when it involves someone that can be tied to the president in even the smallest way. However, conservatives aren't biased when it comes to corruption. We'd like to see it exterminated wherever it exists. In fact, ask any conservative how they feel about John McCain right now, and it's evident there isn't a blind loyalty on the right. But, I digress. As much as Democrats don't want to admit it, the place both bias and corruption seem to thrive best is in their party, so what better place to start investigating than there? After all, we already know there are some dirty deeds worth looking into, but they don't really want corruption weeded out, they only want ammunition against the opposition, thus the current distraction attempt. At the end of the day, this entire Russian collusion theory brought on by Hillary could be the thing that lands her in the big house. After all, the only reason we're learning about the Uranium One scandal is because the left has been hellbent on having not only the public but investigators so hyper-focused on Russia in the first place. One can only imagine what such a council could dig up, and I have a feeling that things are about to heat up in Washington, D.C., very soon. However, the best part will be when these dirty Democrats are sitting in prison as they accidentally shined a light on their own behavior while trying to make someone else look bad. Karma can be a fickle beast at times, and these leftist losers are about to find that out the hard way.